let's meet up tomorrow. How does 12 noon sound for you?
Cyber, sexy cyber, sexy cyber, I love her. Sexy cyber, sexy cyber, cyber,
sexy cyber,
cyber, cyber, cyber, cyber,
sexy cyber.
She's finally about to meet a soulmate. It's still tripping around. She's like, no way. No more sad, lonely nights of straight horror. Tomorrow she's meeting a lover God made for her. She's looking in the mirror, dancing around the house with a mess of clothes on the bed, trying on outfits. She's acting out how the day is probably gonna be like. Hi Pete, I'm so glad we finally get to meet. She thinks to herself, I know what I should do. I'ma call Nicole up and tell her all the good news. And went to voicemail cause Nicole was sleeping. So Lauren left a message like, girl, I'm gonna see him. She hangs up and falls back on the bed smiling, looking at the ceiling, daydreaming in dead silence. Eventually your daydreaming turns into sleep. It's love that she's feeling, and yes, the feeling is sweet.
Cyber, sexy cyber,
sexy cyber,
I love her.
Sexy cyber,
sexy cyber, cyber.
Morning, go dawn, but Lauren's so excited she wakes up before the alarm and calls Pete to see exactly where they're gonna meet. Then Pete picks up and tries to act like he was asleep. Lauren's like, so where we meeting at? We can try my place. Pete's like, nah, how about TGI Fridays? I really love you, Lauren, and I know you trust me, but it's our first time meeting. I don't wanna rush things. She says, that's fine, I'll see you at 12. Until then, I love you, baby, hope you'll be doing well. She takes a shower, does her hair and all that girl stuff. Makeup, lipstick, neck and wrist pearled up. Now it's about time she heads out to tease. She text messages Pete, hey, I'm about to leave. And she's so damn excited as her heart pounds and beats that she almost left the house without her keys. Jeez.
Cyber, sexy cyber,
sexy cyber,
I love her.
Hasn't arrived yet. Should she go in without him? She hasn't decided. She doesn't really know how he would act if she tried it. So she just sits back and just relaxes her eyelids. It's 12:20, Lauren picks up an appetite. She decides to go inside without him and have a bite. Then the phone rings, it's Pete, so she answers it. Pete says, baby, I'm gonna have to cancel it. Lauren says, why? What happened? What is it? Then Pete says, I just heard my grandmother's real sick and I have to go and give her a visit. Then Lauren says, it's okay, baby, go handle your business. She loves him too much, so it didn't really bother. She hops in the car, pulls off, a truck follows her, but she don't even notice cause the music's too loud. And she just caught up in the zone of a ludicrous album. Now she's home, she opens the door, moves to get out. Soon as the foot hits the ground, a man rushes up and pushes her down. She drops the keys, the man picks him up and drags her by her feet into her house like he don't give a fuck. He slapped her, then put tape on her mouth to take from the sound of Lauren screaming rape really loud. He's going ballistic, her face is covered with lipstick. Then he yells out, bitch, Pete never existed. Her head's spinning, then she just faints. The man rips off her clothes and Lauren gets raped. From that day on, nobody ever heard from her, cause that so-called Pete guy went and murdered her. He tossed the body in the off-road ditch. He said he would see you at the crossroad, bitch.
Sexy cyber, sexy cyber, cyber, cyber,
cyber,
sexy cyber,
sexy cyber,
I love her.
Sexy.